summer time after evening chores. We went to see who stood outside knocking on our door. An old man standing quietly, his hat held in his hands, said, "I'd like to have a minute of your time. See, I helped build that barn when I was only 9. He said his name was Beeford as we walked across the fields. And he talked of how they'd raise the frame without a single nail. Just wooden pegs were all it took to make those timbers stand. Then he said, as his eyes looked far away, build it right and it'll last forever and a day." Mr. Beeford's barn still stands on our farm, where it stood 100 years before. Solid as a rock that it was built, talked of how they'd moved down south in 1921, how the farming was much easier and the winters not as long. But he kept a promise to himself to see that barn again just once. Shook our hands and drove away into the setting sun. Late that night, I gazed out of the window by my bed. Down across the meadow, while the moon shone overhead, the old barn stood there silver like a sentry. Once again, I